Hello, hello. Hello. Sorry guys, I am going to share this really quick and then we'll get started, okay? There we are. Hello, how's everybody doing? Hello, hello. Say hi when you're jumping on, guys. Let me switch this really quick. Nope. There we go. Okay. Got it. How's everybody doing? Sunday fun day. Oh my goodness. Okay. All right, we got it. We good.
It's good.
Okay, you guys. Running back over here where I'm actually going to do the live. Okay. All right, we're here. Woo, better lighting, right? All right, this is going to be really shaky just for a hot second. Okay. Oh, God. Bear with me. Hello. Hi, Lisa. Hi, Jenny. Yeah, say hi if you are jumping on, you guys. My hair is kind of like wild. This is slept on curl. I curled it last night. We went to Joe's Christmas party. And this is just like slept on curl right now. So it's a little bit messy, but that's okay. It's all right. We'll rock it. Hello, hello. Okay. So let's get started. How's everyone's weekend been? Good, hopefully. Joe and I finally got out of the house last night. Like I said, it was his Christmas party, but I think it was more for me getting out of the house than him. Okay, so what I'm putting on my face is the VFX Pro face primer, okay? And when you put that on your fingers, I don't know if you've seen it. Sorry, I'm just like jumping right into it. It's more like a, I'll show you here. It's more of a white color, like a moisturizer. Yeah, never long enough. I hear you, Jenny. But yeah, so it's more like a moisturizer. It's got a little bit of almost like an iridescent tone to it, and it just kind of helps give you a glowy look, okay? So still working on getting rid of these breakouts. There's like no bumps. It's flat to the skin, but they're just, the marks are still there because of course I keep picking at them. You guys, I'm such a picker. I wish I could be someone that does not pick at stuff on your face. But yeah, it's not me. Hey, Megan. Hello, girls. Hey, Sadie. How's it going? Okay. So I'm going to use the CC cream foundation today. The last live I did, I think I used the VFX full coverage, but for being just a CC cream foundation, this one does have really good coverage, and the CC stands for color correcting. So like it helps kind of blur any of these like little blemishes, dark circles, anything like that. So I'm going to move my hair back here. Okay. So did anyone do anything fun this weekend? So I'm gonna put this right on my finger, just like that. So I use light to medium. So then I just spread this on these three fingers. And then I roughly apply it all over my face with my fingers. The only other thing I have on my face, you guys, is I just have my eyeliner and my eyelashes already on. I didn't feel like doing that in the video because it just makes the video longer and longer. Okay, so get that all spread out. It's a very rough application, and then I go in with my blending bud and I like press it all in. And then I just pull it down onto my neck a little bit just to kind of get it to blend. You don't have to go all the way like down or anything, but just like that, okay? Okay, so then I take my little blending bud here. Mine is not damp. It's just hit or miss. Sometimes I'll dampen it, sometimes I won't. Just kind of go with what you feel. I'm really technical, I know. Okay. Tawny, this is Farmasi's CC cream that I'm using. It's really nice because the CC stands for color correcting. So like, look at how well it already covered up those blemishes, and that's without concealer. So it's pretty awesome. I love it because during the week, if I don't really want to wear my like full coverage foundation, I'll just throw this on and just kind of rock that for the day. And I still feel like I get really good coverage, and it still looks really flawless. Tawny, that's your favorite one. I know, girl, I'm so hooked. I thought I was like, I thought the VFX was my favorite, but now I can't even decide between the CC cream and the VFX. They're both so good. And the great thing is they're both really, really lightweight. Even the full coverage one is really lightweight. Like, I don't even feel like I'm wearing makeup. Hi, Christina. Sorry, just seen you pop on there. Okay, you guys, I have something in my eye. Okay, so I got that all pressed in. I usually do two coats of the CC cream. Once I get it pressed in, I'll grab another coat of it. But I wanted to get my eye primer here before I started putting it on my eyes as well. How do you color match your face? I'm not sure. Christina, as far as color matching, just shoot me a message and I can help you get color matched. I usually have anyone that's wanting to get the, like, try the makeup that I use or anything, just send me a picture of themselves. You can send me a picture with and without makeup. I really need the picture without makeup so that I can see your natural undertones. And then if you want, you can include a picture of yourself with makeup so that I can see kind of how you like to wear your foundation. Some people like to wear, some people like to match their face with their foundation. Other people like to, that's how they like to add color to their face, is their foundation. Me personally, hi Caitlin. Me personally, I like to try to match my face as close as possible, and then I add color with like my contour and bronzer and blush and everything like that. So it's really just personal preference on how you like to wear your makeup. So to answer that, Christina, just shoot me a picture of yourself with and without makeup on in natural light, and I can help you get matched up. Okay. Stay matte? You like stay matte? That's like your first, really? Wow. See, I haven't even tried stay matte yet. You guys, there's so many different options for foundation, for every skin type, everything. Okay, so that was the eye primer that I put on my eyes. If you noticed, it made them look a lot like lighter as well. The eye primer is just gonna keep the makeup on your eyes throughout the day. It's going to help it so that it doesn't like wear off or anything like that, or get too oily on your eyelids or anything. So I just grabbed some more of the CC cream. And then any of the areas that I feel like need concealed more, I'll go in with that second layer and I'll just put that on there. Again, really rough application because I press everything in with my sponge. Okay, good luck, right? Okay, so taking this, pressing everything in. Say hi when you're jumping on, you guys. I hope everyone is having a fantastic Sunday. I kind of got to sleep in a little bit today. We didn't sleep the greatest last night. Asher is still trying to get these bottom teeth in, you guys. I feel like every video I get on here, I'm saying he's teething, but it is like real life. He's teething. Hello, Alexandria, how are you? Hi, Callie. Kelly, how's your baby boy? Is he feeling better? Okay, so then any of the excess on the sponge, I take and I put on my eyelids here. Okay. Hi, Mindy, how are you? Hey, Lynette. How was your weekend? I'm really jealous. camping and out in the dunes. Oh, that sounds like a blast. Oh, well, I'm glad he's feeling better, Callie. That's miserable, especially when your little ones don't feel good. Nobody feels good. Jace, oh, he's getting his two-year molars. Girl. Asher is, yeah, no, I feel like he's been teething, like, the entire time I've had him. That's what it feels like, anyways. This is the lip moisturizer, or the lip conditioner. Sorry, I'm drawing a blank. And I just like to put a little bit of this on as I'm doing my makeup so that it has time to soak in and absorb in my lip. Got to keep the moisture on the lips in the winter. Okay, you guys, so this was just the CC cream. Like, I feel like I could just rock this, just walk out the door like this for the day, and I would be totally fine with it. Mindy, you fell in love with the CC cream. I know, girl, isn't it bomb? Oh, I love it. Okay. All right. So, next, we are going to go in with the Light Ivory Concealer. I'm going to be scraping the bottom of this. I got my other one that I haven't opened yet. Just got my shipment in yesterday. So, it's just like a little applicator like this, and I will put it right under here. So, I like around my eyes to be very bright. Okay. And I just kind of fan this out in a triangle section here. So this whole section right here. And so that's going to help highlight, because I go with such a light color. It's not just covering up my dark circles. It is also highlighting my face. So I have a highlight stick. I don't use it. I mostly use my concealer to highlight. But once I play around with the highlight stick a little bit more, then I can do a tutorial with that one. I just haven't got a chance to really play with it too much. Sadie, yes, girl, get you a CC cream. You're gonna fall in love. Okay, so then I put this right here on my chin. So any areas that, like, say if you, like, think of it like the sun shining down on your face, like, where would the sun hit? You know, it's like here, nose, little bit of your forehead, chin, the top of your lip. That's kind of how I try to think about it as far as, like, for the highlighting part. And you don't have to get a concealer that's this light. You can get one that's only, like maybe just, like, one shade or even just half a shade lighter than your foundation if you're not trying to highlight with it, if you're just trying to, like, cover blemishes or dark circles or something. Yeah. Okay, so then I take the skinny part, the tip right here, and I just start pressing in the concealer. Okay. Okay, so I'm just pressing this all in, okay? Nothing, like, real strategic or anything. I'm not, like, wiping or swiping at it or anything. I'm just pressing. So, like, just so you can kind of get the idea of how I'm doing this. Because if you're wiping at it, I feel like you're just, like, you're wiping part of it off, you know? Pressing it, you're actually just pressing it into the skin. Okay? And I start kind of on these outer edges here. And then I kind of look up. As you go underneath your eye, you can kind of look up. That way you're not, like, feel like you're gonna jab your eye or something. Any of the excess that's on the sponge, I take it across my eyelid here. I feel like that just kind of helps my eyelid pop a little bit more. Because I'm really, in this live, I'm not going to do a whole lot for eyeshadow. I might do a little bit, like, with my contour color and my highlight powder. I'll show you how to make it look like eyeshadow, kind of. But other than that, I'm really not going to be doing much for eyeshadow in this live. Okay, so just pressing that in there. Caitlin, yes, I am wearing lashes. Yep, I started out the video with just eyeliner on the top, and then I have my lashes on, I think. I want to say these are the Kiss brand that I'm wearing, I believe. Don't quote me on that, but I'm pretty sure these are the Kiss brand. And I think they're called Wispies, I think. Okay, so get that pressed in. That way it looks nice, light, and bright. And then I grab my transparent finishing powder. I'm starting to run out. You can see the bottom of it there. Okay, so then I grab my fluffy brush like this. And I'm gonna set anywhere that I put concealer. I'm gonna use my contour stick, but I always like to set my concealer like right away. Okay, and then even on my eyelids here, I'm dusting it across there, the transparent finishing powder. Just setting anywhere that I brought that concealer over to, okay? That way, that is going to ensure that your makeup ain't gonna move. Not till you wash it off. So, the transparent finishing powder, that's one of my must-haves, like whenever people get like foundation or anything, I'm like, oh, have you looked at the finishing powder though? Make sure you get that. I love it. So I always push it on people because I'm like, it's my jam. Like I started seeing the bottom of this. I was like, oh my God, I have to order more. Alexandra, you got a color that's too dark. Oh no. Blend, girl. Blend, blend, blend. The contour stick that I'm going to use, Farmasi only has one color. It looks really dark, okay? But it blends in beautifully, okay? So stay tuned for this. I'm going to throw my brows on real quick. Any of you that have tuned in for any of my lives, you're like, yeah, right, brows real quick. And so I have switched from the O2, what is it, the medium or the light brown or something. I've switched from that pomade to the blonde or the light color, and I like it a lot more. It's just a lot softer. Okay. Gonna use my handy dandy Farmasi brushes. They're animal print, you guys. They are animal print. Oh, sorry, I'm being a dork. Okay. So, grab my flat angled brush here, and that's what I use to do my eyebrows. Any of you that are curious how I do my eyebrows that have not caught my eyebrow video, here's a little treat for you. I'm trying to get this. There was something on there. Okay. Okay. So, animal print. You don't have to get the animal print, but I'm a huge fan of it. So, so it is it's angled and then it's flat. Okay. Flat angled brush, hence the name. All right. So I dip that into the pomade right there, and then I take it and wipe each side so that it gives me a nice precise line. So I have got these little puny baby eyebrows here, and I have to kind of extend it forward. And then I'm drawing the top of them here. Not really going too in depth with how I do it. If any of you have questions about like certain makeup or brushes or whatever that I'm using, you can ask on here. But if I miss your question, just shoot me a message, okay? And I will hop back on later tonight and answer any questions that I missed. And then just put a mark on my face here. Okay, so there's the outer shape of that one. Sadie, I really like the brushes. They're really, really soft and they have a really good application to them. So I was really excited about that because I wasn't sure either. I'm like, oh, am I going to like these brushes? But no, I'm a big fan of them. I will reach for this, the Farmasi brush over my other flat angled brush from my other set of brushes here. I will reach for this one for my eyebrows first before the other one. I like this one. Yes. Yeah. You'll have to let me know how you like the brushes when they come in. I have a hair that's like hanging down on my face. It's gonna, about to get some eyebrow pomade on it. And then I try to just be very like light-handed towards the front of my brow here because I don't like it to be as dark as the rest of my brow. Because if you look at someone's natural eyebrow that actually has like really full eyebrows, the front of their brow is usually lighter than the rest of it. Okay, and then moving on to this one over here. And for those of you that either haven't caught me doing like my alive with eyebrows or anything like that, the eyebrow pomade, it does dry, which is awesome. So then you're not like, I don't know, I felt like with my last, the last company I was with, I loved the wax and powder. That was like the first time I had used a wax and powder for my brows. And I really liked like the look it gave me, but I felt like every time I touched my eyebrow, it would like, I'd get like a line or it would crease or something. Like I felt like I couldn't touch my brows all day. It's like, do them and then leave them, don't touch them. But with this eyebrow pomade, it actually will dry. So I'm not like to get it off at night, I have to like scrub. I have to scrub this off, which is great though, because I sure as heck don't want it coming off throughout the day. Okay. Then I grab my eyebrow powder. This is the light brown. And I'm taking the same brush that I used the pomade with here. And you seem like I barely touched it. Sadie, you're so funny. Yeah, girl, it's so addicting. Like, I swear, every time I put in, like, a bulk order for some of my local ladies, I swear, I will add in, you know, a few extra things. I'm like, oh, I should probably try this and try that. Oh, my goodness. Okay. All right. So then I grab this brush right here, and that is what I actually use to, like, I use the bristly part right here, and I just kind of use that to kind of brush my brows out just a little bit and to soften the front of it. And it just makes sure that your, like, eyebrow hairs are laying down right and everything. So we will leave that just like that. All right, so for the contouring part, what brush do you use for your eyebrows? Brenna, I was just showing them. These are the Farmasi brushes here, the animal print ones, of course. And so it comes with four brushes, the pack of it here, and you get a fluffy powder brush here, a foundation brush, an eyeshadow brush, and a angled flat brush. And I've actually been using the angled flat brush for my eyebrows. Hello, Anne. Okay, so drum roll. Brrr. Okay. Contour stick. So when I put this on, it looks crazy. Like, it looks like it's gonna be too much. But it blends out so beautifully. So just stay tuned to see how this blends out, okay? Bear with me. Okay, so when you're contouring, I tell people, to kind of find, like, you almost want to put it, like, in the hollows of your cheek right here, to make your cheekbones up here pop out. Because I put my highlighter up here to make it nice and bright, so it kind of hits this area right here. And then contouring is, like, right under the cheekbone. So putting a shadow underneath there makes your cheekbones pop out more, okay? So to find that area, I tell people, make a fishy face. And you kind of, so see the line of that? So I'm going to make that face while I'm drawing this on so you can kind of see how I do that, okay? I'm going to try to do it without laughing. Do you see how I figured that out there? There, I just followed that line all the way back, okay? See that? And then I go right under my lip. I used to be, like, deathly scared of contour sticks. Like, I always contour with powder. And so a contour stick just scared me. But this was actually one of the free gifts that they sent me for reaching, like, a certain mark in with the company. I'm going to move this a little bit. There we go. So they actually sent me this for free. And so I'm like, okay, well, I have to at least try it, right? And I love it. I really, really love it. So then I go on the sides of my nose. Down here. And then right across this little area. I know, does this not look like crazy? So then I like to put it right up here too, because I feel like I have a little bit of, I don't know, I feel like I have a little bit of a like square-ish round type face shape. And so the ideal face shape is oval. So that is what you're trying to create when you're highlighting and contouring. You're trying to create the look of an oval face shape. So I'm literally etching out and like drawing on that oval shape, and then I blend this out, okay? So you can see how that's starting to make it look more oval, right? And then right along here, so I kind of fill that in and that little area right there. So then and then I usually kind of draw right back in there too. Okay, and that's not a big deal. You'll buff that in. It's okay. Okay, so doesn't that look crazy, you guys? Should I just leave it like this? I think I should just leave it. No, just kidding. But yeah, so I grab my kabuki brush. So a kabuki brush is a flat compact brush, and it makes it nice because you can like buff things out, or you can buff in like your foundation. A lot of times I'll use this for my VFX full coverage foundation, and I'll put the foundation on my hand, tap it, and I'll tap it around my face and then like buff it all in. But I also like to use my kabuki brush to buff in the contour. Okay, so real interesting look here. So then you just start working in circular motions here. It's like so scary at first when you draw those like harsh lines on your face. So when in doubt, just keep blending, okay? And then circular motions all down in here where I put that contour line. So see how like how pretty that looks when you blend it out? Ah, it's so pretty. So that's why I say, like, if you're thinking like your contour is too dark or anything, when in doubt, just keep blending, girl. And then I just kind of work that in a little bit. And then down here. So then it kind of creates a little bit of a shadow under your lip here to make it look a little bit like it's like a little bit more pouty sticking out there. Okay, so then back in here. And I kind of pull my hair back away from my face when I'm doing this. So see how pretty that blends out. Okay, so then come over here. And you just kind of keep working that in. Okay, and then again, I kind of hold my hair back here. Okay, so see how pretty that blended in? I know, I'm not done with my nose. I didn't forget, girl. So nobody did anything fun this weekend? You guys are being pretty quiet. I was just excited to get out of the house finally. I feel like the weather's been so crappy that we've just been staying in and oh, mama needed to get out. So then, like right here, if I feel like this is just me being kind of picky here, I'm just gonna take my finger. Caitlin, your hubby's out of town. Holding down the fort on your own, huh? Target run, yes, girl. Find anything good? I always find more than I need at Target. Always. So then I'm gonna take my transparent finishing powder again, and I just set all of the contour that I just did, okay? Hey Jennifer, how are you? Alexandria, yes. Yeah, girl, that's me too. I go into Target, I'm like, okay, I need this, this, and this. Come out, cart full of stuff. Like, well, you know, it happens. Oh my goodness. Okay. So set all of that. My hair is just like all over the place because I'm just like pushing it all around. Okay. What you guys think? You liking it? Give me some hearts if you like it. Jennifer, yeah. Caitlin, I know, it's like, all of a sudden you feel like you have to buy more like cute hampers or throw pillows or it's just like, I don't need any of this. I don't need any of it. Oh, Thank you, Caitlin. So yeah, so here's like the finish of like my highlight, my contour. I do, obviously I still use like highlight powder and everything, but this is kind of just like my base face right here with my eyebrows. And then as you guys can see, I have my lashes on. So yeah, let's see here. I am not even going to do any like eyeshadow per se. I am just going to, just to like enhance my eyes a little bit. Basket junkie, for real. Okay, so this is the 3-in-1 palette. You guys, this palette is gorgeous. And it's only like, what is it? Like $18 for your contour color, a really pretty pigmented highlight powder, and a blush. Like, you cannot beat it. I try to like get everyone that wants like a foundation, I'm like, girl, you gotta get the 3-in-1 palette too. So I am actually just taking the contour color and I'm just gonna put it in the crease of my eye because like I said, I'm not really doing anything like that intricate on my eye because this was more so a video to show like highlight and contour. So I'm just throwing some of my contour powder right in the crease just to make my eyelid pop a little bit more. So you can see like it just adds a little bit of depth to your eyes when you do that. Like don't even need an eyeshadow, just use your contour powder. Okay. You guys, be sure to tune in next Sunday. I know it's Super Bowl Sunday, but I'm going to be live and Head Kandy is going to be on as well. And we all know that those usually turn into giveaways if we get enough shares. So be sure to tune in next Sunday here on my page. I will be live. I'll be doing a fun little Super Bowl hair look. Might even throw in a bandana. Might have some black streaks on my face. So tune in, okay? It should be fun. It's going to be a fun one. And I hope they do a giveaway during it so that someone wins something. The last one, my girl Brenna, she won a wand. I'm so excited. I was so stoked. But yeah, okay. Back on track. So then I'm taking the Star Look mascara. And this one, it's kind of like fatter here towards the bottom and then it gets really skinny. I like this. This brush because you can really kind of get into the corner of your eye with like where your lashes are here. Okay. And I do have, hey Brenna, but, yeah, I do have lashes on, so I don't need to like really go too in depth here with, I'm just blending my lashes with these lashes. And then it just, like, if you put the mascara on the ends of, oh, really? It never fails, you guys. It never fails. I have a mascara dot. Give me some little laughy faces if this has ever happened to you. Ever. Because it happens to me, like, every time I do my makeup, I swear. I'm going to have to end up going to get a Q-tip. Okay, it's not too bad. It could be worse. You guys, I am a hot mess. I'm a hot mess. Oh my God. Oh, goodness gracious. Okay. Just take my transparent setting powder here. Touch that little spot up. See? Easy fix. It's okay. It just seems like I do that all the time. Okay, we're gonna attempt this again. Shouldn't probably even get this out. Brenna. Always. More times than not, it happens to me when I'm doing a live as well. Of course, right? So see, it just kind of adds some definition and separation to the fake lashes if you put mascara on them. Okay. Then I'm gonna take my little flat brush here, or not flat, my more compact brush, and I'm gonna take that same contour color and just kind of dust it along my lash line, like my bottom lash line. Okay, so it just adds a little bit of a smoky effect to it. You guys, I haven't used one eyeshadow palette or anything. I've only used my contour color on my eyes. It's pretty great. Then take my mascara, and we're gonna risk this again. So as you can see, it kind of allows you to get in this corner a little bit more. Look at how like pretty and soft it makes those like bottom lashes. Those are just my bottom lashes. And I really don't even have that much down there, but I really like this mascara. I haven't got a chance to try my Extreme Curl mascara yet. I've been told that it's like the bomb. So I'm really excited to try it. I just got it in yesterday. Okay. Pretty, right? I didn't even use anything besides a contour color. And I do have, with my lashes, before I put my lashes on, I use the ink liner. I don't need to apply anything or do anything with the ink liner, I don't think. I guess I could touch up like right here. Take that back. Yeah, there we go. I like that. There's that. And then I have really, really, really been liking, I use a combo of white and black eyeliner on my waterline because I don't know what it is, but on the outer corner out here, I just really like having my black on the waterline. But then the white, because I had never really used white before up until like a couple weeks ago when I got this in. I just wanted to try it because I just wanted to see what the hype was about, you know, making your eyes look bigger with white eyeliner, this and that. I don't really personally like using it on my entire waterline. I like a little bit of the black right in the corner, and then I use the white the rest of the way. So I'll show you what I mean here. So I just kind of work that right in that area. You feel like mascara rubs off on your eyelids. Abby, shoot me a message. I'm not really sure why. do you let your mask, like your mascara dry and everything, like it just rubs off? Or you should try an eye primer, because that mattifies like any oils on your eyelids, and that'll help prevent your eyelids from being too oily. Because if your eyelids are too oily, it probably is like rubbing your mascara off on there. So definitely make sure you're using like a mattifying eye primer, because you have to use a different primer on your eyes than for your face, because your eyelids, the skin is different on your eyelids. Okay, so see, I just did the black right on the like halfway point to the outer corners for my waterline, and then I grabbed the white. Hi, Stephanie, how are you? Like that. And then I'll take my black again. So then it just kind of, I feel like, still keeps the inner part of my eye really open and looking like bigger. I'm not currently using a primer for my eyes. Yeah, no problem, Abby. I hope that helps. Shoot me a message and let me know. Okay, put that on that inner part, and then I just kind of take the black. I've just been trying a lot of different things lately, just for the heck of it. So, okay. So that is like the half and half, the black and white there. Okay. Digging it. All right, then I'm grabbing my fluffy brush here. It's already got my blush color on there. And I'm grabbing the blush from the 3-in-1 face palette here. It's a really pretty pink color. I'm not usually a blush person, but I don't know. I've been, like I said, switching it up and trying different things, and I really like this blush color that comes with this. Just so good. Aw, you took a nap with your little baby. Aw. Those are the best. I'm a terrible nap taker, so when I actually, like, take a nap with Asher, it's wonderful. Pretty sure I have FOMO, because it's like, as soon as, like, I don't know, it just, I just can't nap. Oh, I think like I should be doing something or. Okay. So these are just like little extra things that I really like. So this is the Terracotta Blush Powder. It's kind of like a bronzy powder, very, very shimmery. So you can see that. It's just like, look at how like pigmented and shimmery that is. I love it. So then I take my smaller brush here and I will just kind of pop that right on my cheekbone right there where my blush is, just to kind of give it a shimmer. Same thing over here. Like, look at how shimmery it is. I love it. And I'll dust a little bit there. Okay, pretty, right? Love that stuff. And then I will grab the highlight powder. Sorry, you guys can see my ring light there. The highlight powder right here in the 3-in-1 face palette. And I'll take like my ring finger on that. And I put a little bit on my nose. There. Inner eye. My brow bone right there. Again, real technical here, using my finger. I'm just keeping it real, girls. Ain't nobody got time to be grabbing a different brush for every single thing. Sometimes you just gotta use your fingers or your hands or something. Put that on my Cupid's bow there. Then I take this brush, same one that I used to put the blush powder, the kind of the bronzy stuff on there. And I just dust it off on a towel. And I put that more towards this inner part because it's shimmery like the terracotta blush powder, but it's a little bit lighter. So I put it in towards the front of my cheekbone here and work it kind of up. And then I don't grab any more product on. I just kind of diffuse what I put on my nose. I'll kind of dust that a little bit. Grab that. Hi, Belinda. How are you? Okay, so then I just want to show you guys to add, because I only did the contour in the crease of my eye, I'm taking the highlight powder here. And I'm putting that just right on my eyelid. And that's just highlight powder, okay? It's not going to make a huge difference, but it's going to give you a little bit more of a shimmer. Okay. I've been pretty good. Pretty good, Belinda. Thank you for asking. Let's see here. Okay, so I'm just going to finish up with my lips here. I'm going to do a nude lip. I've been like really, really, really digging this color that I got. It's called Skin. It's in the matte liquid lipstick, 201 here. But yeah, I've been loving this color. This is like my go-to color right now. This one and Brave, 205. Brave is like, it's a favorite with everybody. And then, okay. Okay, so my makeup kind of covered up my little mole that I got right there. So I take my darkest lip liner. And I just make that mark there. Okay. I am going to use this lip liner on my lips as well. They don't have names for the lip liners. This is the Farmasi lip liners. This is number 227. These bad boys are only like $6. What are they, like $6.45, $6.95, something like that. For a really good lip liner that stays on. Okay. Okay, so there's the bottom. Okay, there's that side. I love this color. Especially with like a nude lip, it's really pretty. And then I just kind of feather it in just a little bit. You guys, I still can't believe like No eyeshadow. This is not eyeshadow. This was my 3-in-1 face palette. I use the contour color for my crease and the highlight powder for my eyelids and like inner and brow bone. I love it. This makeup is like, it's super versatile. Versatile. However you say it. Tomato, tomato. Okay, so I'm looking at something here. There we go. Okay, so it looks really dark. If you want to, you can even, so we'll start with Brave and we'll put it right just in the corners. So put that just in that corner. That one in that corner. So this, by doing this, I'm kind of like ombreing my lips, okay? This is the skin color. So it's a very like, I don't know if you can see that or not. It's a very like, just a nude skin color, I guess. I don't know, it's kind of got some like grayish undertones to it. So you can see that's the color of it. I love it because these lippies are like so lightweight. So lightweight. What do you guys think about that color? Are we liking it? Yes, no. Thank you, Belinda, you're so sweet. Okay, I have been liking putting the lip plumper on top of the nude color. It just gives it a really like, just a really shiny, pretty color. Add that. Thank you, ladies. Okay, so this is the finished look. I am digging it. I'm digging it. You guys like it? So it's nothing like crazy. I didn't do any crazy eyeshadow, anything like that. But yeah, it was just something that I kind of wanted to show you guys. Thank you all for staying tuned for the whole video. I know these makeup videos get a little bit longer, but just to kind of explain everything and break it all down for you guys, that just kind of adds a lot of time on there. But yeah, so like I said, I will probably go live again. Thank you. Thank you so much, ladies. I will probably go live again at some point this week, but next Sunday, like I said, tune into my page and I will be live and Head Kandy will be on. And we'll be doing a fun like Super Bowl Sunday look. So you come hang out, see what craziness I've got going on, what I got up my sleeve. But yeah, so be sure to tune into that. You guys, my YouTube channel is growing. It is growing, but it's a nice like slow and steady pace. But if you guys have not subscribed to my channel yet, please, please, please go subscribe. Go check out some of my videos on there. My hubby does a lot of work to my YouTube channel for me. I give him my ideas, my input, and he like brings it all to life. So please go check that out. It's Tori's Beauty Tribe on YouTube. Subscribe, watch the videos, comment, like anything. And then also, if you are liking any of the tips and tricks I give, or if you, thank you so much, my necklace. But yeah, so share the love, just, you know, share the video, whatever, you know, any support. I appreciate it. So, and stay tuned because I've got some other surprises that I ordered from Amazon, and I'll be showing you guys those too. I've always got something up my sleeve, you guys. But yeah, and you guys will notice that my page is going to start blowing up with a lot of like welcome pictures and posts to a lot of girls that have joined my team. Sorry, but I've been slacking on the welcome post, so you're about to get bombarded with them. So, but I just love welcoming ladies to my team, and I'm so excited that I've got so many awesome ladies joining me. But yeah, you guys, if you have not tried Farmasi makeup yet, hit me up, girl. I will hook you up. But yeah, for real, just message me if you have any questions on anything, and I look forward to seeing you guys next live. I'll see you guys later. Have a great Sunday.